God save you.
I've done as you asked.
Excellent, Henry. I look forward to the latest news from Talmberg. I hope Captain Robart rubs the commander's nose right in it.
Have you got any more jobs for me?
Of course. You're just in time. I could do with a horse. And since I'm setting the task, I'll go further. I'd like a strong stallion direct from the Myrhoyed stables.
Now that's no mean feat you're asking.
As well I know. And well I'll pay.
I'll steal that horse for you, but the reward had better be worth it.
Don't worry. But you'd best not come back with some old nag.
I've got some goods here whose owners might miss them.
All right. Let's see what we can do about that.
I've got some goods here whose owners might miss them.
All right. Let's see what we can do about that.
I'd like to discuss the price.
Here. And something for your trouble.
Be a bit more careful.
Hey, look out! Mercy, sir.
Get out of here.
Please, sir, help me.
What's happened to you?
I've walked all the way from Kuttenberg, but as you can see, I'm barefoot. My feet are frayed to the bone. Don't you have a strip of clean cloth for me, good sir, so I can swathe my feet at least?
Wait, I'll see what I've got.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. I seldom meet such a good Samaritan. God shall repay you.
Anytime. Take care now.
Good day to you. What do you need?
I'm honored that a knight is as you.
I'm looking for a fellow who lives here, but I don't know his name. Do you know anyone with a limp?
What would you want with him? Well, it's no skin off my nose. The bastard has a cottage on the edge of the village by the road to Ratte.
Good day to you. What do you need?
I'd like to discuss the price.
Naturally.
We agreed?
Come now, just a little more and we have a deal. Finally, a reasonable sum.
Can we do something about the price?
Well, we can try it. See now, I knew we'd come to an agreement.
Move along, citizens. Move along. There's nothing to see here.
That's what you call nothing to see. I'd like to know what something to see looks like.
By the keys of St. Peter, this is all I need. We'll have to send word to Sir Hanush.
That might not be necessary.
Who are you?
I'm Henry of Scalitz, in the service of Hanush's Captain Bernard. I'm investigating the attack at Neuhof, and I think this could be related.
Well, I'm the bailiff of Auschwitz. And I say we don't want any of that kind of trouble around here. What makes you think this has anything to do with Neuhof?
One of the folk at the stud farm recognized someone from Auschwitz among the bandits.
We have no bandits or murderers around here.
Really? They say he had a limp?
Shit. Well, allow me to introduce you to Limpy Lubosch, or all that's left of him.
Sakra. Oh, nothing's ever easy.
I'll have to take a look around and ask a few more questions, if that's all right with you.
You can take this mess off my hands and welcome to it. As for what else there is to find out, I don't know. But look and ask all you like.
Who was Limpy Lubosch?
A poor crofter and a scoundrel. Can't say I'm too surprised what happened to him. He kept company with all sorts of vermin. He was always getting into some kind of trouble. Punch-ups in the tavern and what have you.
How come he limped?
He got that from some villainy or brawl a long time ago.
Has he been up to anything suspicious lately?
I don't know. The last few days he didn't go anywhere. He was home the whole time. But he always kept everyone in the village at arm's length.
Did he have any kith or kin in the village?
None. A loner he was. I don't know the last time I saw him with anyone.
Do you happen to know where he was on the night of the Neuhof raid?
I've no idea. He kept his distance from other folk, so you never knew if he was away or holed up at home.
When did you find the body? And did anyone see anything?
Just now. And nobody saw or heard anything. I don't know how they could gut him like that without someone hearing him scream.
Lord above, they did a hell of a job on him. Must have been agony. How come no one heard anything? An inscription in blood. It's a pity I don't know how to read. Looks like they wanted to give someone a warning. But who? And a bandit who knows how to write isn't something you see every day.
God be with you.
I've come in the name of Sir Hanush of Lipa. I'm investigating the massacre in Neuhof, and now a murder here as well. Can I ask you a few questions?
Of course. Ask away.
That man Lubosch who was murdered, what was he like?
He was a drunk who was always looking for a fight. Nobody liked him much, but I wouldn't wish an end like that on any man.
Have you noticed anything suspicious recently?
Well, now I think of it, I hadn't seen him around for a while. No idea where he was skulking.
Do you know anyone Lubosch used to spend time with? Relatives or friends?
He was a loner. He didn't even have any mates in the tavern.
Do you know what Lubosch was doing the day Neuhof was raided?
Not a clue.
That's all. Thank you.
I'm at your service, Sir Knight.
I'd like to learn to read.
You? You don't look like the makings of a priest or clerk. But why not? I've taught all sorts. Bear in mind, it won't be all that easy. You'll need plenty of time and a few groschen for my trouble.
All right. I don't want to waste time. We can get started. The sooner I master it, the better.
Very well. I will require some groschen from you, though, and set aside at least a couple of days so I can put you through your paces, if indeed time is of the essence.
Here are your groschen.
Then we may as well start.
No. He did break his vow, but better than to dishonor it here. May he follow his heart.
Wake up, lad. It's time we were getting on. So, let's see you read a bit. There's a book here on the table. Try to read it.
Will I manage?
You ought to be able to. It's a simple text. Come back once you've worked your way through it.
I've read the book.
Wonderful. So tell me, what have you learned?
That being greedy doesn't pay.
Excellent. You're one of my most talented pupils. You've uncovered the meaning hidden in the letters. Like I told you, books are valuable. And the words that you place in them ought to be no less so.
Does that mean that I can read then?
Yes, you have the foundation. Remember, my boy, the pen is mightier than the sword. To fully learn your way around words will take a lot more reading yet. Now we'll move on to the second lesson, which will be much harder. Many books are written in Latin, the language of erudite and religious men. If you really want to be able to read, there's no getting away from Latin. There's a book on the table with some text. Read it and then come back. You need not understand it, but you should master the letters.
I only just managed the fable about the goose, and now you're asking me to tackle Latin.
You're a clever lad. You'll manage.
I read the page.
So tell me, Distrupule, what's written there?
Nullus est liber tam malus, ut non aliquae parte prosit.
Good heavens! Don't tell me you haven't had lessons before. Excellent. Well, there's nothing more I can teach you. Congratulations. You can go and be ordained right away.
Thank you, Domine. I'm feeling a lot wiser.
Judas. Looks like this is meant to be a warning. But for who? And why? Maybe the gang had a falling out. But a bandit who knows how to write isn't something you see every day. What's this? Looks like someone's hit him very hard on the head. Could they have bludgeoned him to death and then gutted him? That would explain why he didn't scream. Lord above, they did a hell of a job on him. Must have been agony. How come no one heard anything? I've come in the name of Sir Hanish of Lipa. I'm investigating the massacre in Neuhof, and now a murder here as well. Can I ask you a few questions?
Ask away.
Who was this Lubosch who was murdered?
He was a drunkard and a beast, and lazy too. Idle hands are the devil's tools.
Have you noticed anything suspicious recently?
The only thing seems suspicious was how a rogue like him suddenly started going to church. Now I see why, of course.
Do you know what Lubosch was doing the day Neuhof was raided?
What do I care about that scoundrel? I was glad he stayed out of my way.
Do you know who Lubosch used to spend time with? Kin or friends?
He was always a loner. Except lately, he started talking to the parish priest, of all people.
That's all. Thank you.